So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of Government Schemes. In this session guys, I will bring to you another very important scheme jiska naam hai Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. Okay guys, this scheme is very important. So let's talk about this, but before we begin, if you are new here, you do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. And also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. All right. And this is the scheme guys that we are going to discuss today, Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. So let's talk about the objective first, and first of all let us do those things that we can do effortlessly, jisko aapko dobara se kabhi padhne ki zarurat nahi padni chahiye. Aur usme se sabse pehli cheez kya hai, the objective of the scheme. All right, so what is the objective? So there are three important words. One is paramparagat. So what is the meaning of paramparagat? Paramparagat means the in the traditional way. All right. And what is the meaning of Krishi? Krishi means agriculture, and Vikas means what? Development. So the guys, Vikas word is very famous in Indian politics, India politics in these days. So paramparagat ka matlab samajh mein aata hai hame, traditional way hai. And Krishi Vikas ka matlab kya hai? Agricultural development. So the basic objective of this scheme is to promote the traditional ways of agriculture. Okay. Is to promote the traditional ways of agriculture. Now what are these traditional way of agriculture? So guys, if you talk about the old days when there were no no pesticides, no fertilizers, so us samay hum kin cheezon ka istemal karte the? We used to use the basic manures and the natural things. Okay, the farming was completely organic. So basically the objective behind this scheme is to promote the organic farming and thereby promoting the traditional ways for the agriculture development. Okay, traditional ways ko jo aaj ki science hai uske sath connect karke jo hame organic farming hai usko kya karna hai, promote karna hai. Okay, to promote the organic farming by connecting the traditional ways and the today's modern science. All right, so I hope guys the objective is clear. And ministry guys, of course, is the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, and you have to confirm about the minister before your exam. And talking about the institutional framework, so that you also don't have to remember, it is just for the basic understanding. So there is a National Advisory Committee which is chaired by the secretary in the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, and this National Advisory Committee will provide the overall guidelines to the principal to the scheme. Then we have State Department of Agriculture or any agency that is nominated by the state government. So this department has the responsibility of implementing the scheme. Then we have district level executive committee that is chaired by the district collector. Okay, so this is the institutional mechanism. Sabse upar national level pe there is National Advisory Committee which is headed by the secretary and the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Then we have State Department of Agriculture or any agency that is nominated by the state government, and then we have district level executive committee which is headed by the district collector. All right. And if you talk about the approach, now ye jo organic farming hai isko kaise approach kiya jayega, so PKVY, which means Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana, promotes organic farming through a cluster approach to adopt PGS certification. So basically kya hoga, farmers ko incentive provide karaye jayenge ki wo apne farming mein use kar sake keval organic cheeze. Okay, so the farmers are provided with the incentive so that they can use only organic things for the agriculture. Okay, और इसमें पीजीएस सर्टिफिकेशन लेना जरूरी है. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस पीजीएस सर्टिफिकेशन? सो पीजीएस स्टैंड्स फॉर पार्टिसिपेटरी गारंटी सिस्टम, एंड एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट फार्मर्स आर प्रोवाइडेड द इंसेंटिव्स फॉर यूजिंग ऑर्गेनिक थिंग्स इन देयर फार्म, इन देयर फार्म्स और फॉर द एग्रीकल्चर. दैट इंसेंटिव पार्ट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जाम, दैट इज वेरी इलेबोरेटिव थिंग, सो दैट यू डोंट हैव टू रिमेंबर एंड इवन यू डोंट हैव टू रीड वंस. ऑलराइट, so PGS stands for participatory guarantee system. This system facilitates farmer to certify their organic produce, label them and market them directly to the consumers. Okay, so basically PGS jo certification system hai wo kya hai, jo farmer ka produce hoga usko labeling karne ke liye kaam aayega ki wo organic hai ya nahi hai. Aur ye do tarike ki labeling hoti hai, PGS India green ke liye ye label hai, while PGS India organic ke liye ye label hai. So if there is a label or the logo of PGS India green on any produce, which means that this that produce is under the process of becoming the organic. Okay, agar PGS India green ka logo hai to wo produce abhi 100% organic nahi hai, that is under process, while if there is a logo of PGS India organic, then which means that that produce is 100% organic now. Okay, so these are the two types of logo. So this is the basic approach that government is following to promote the organic farming. And this approach, guys, also you don't have to remember. Just remember this, just memorize this logo. Is logo ka naam, is logo ko apne dimag mein aapko rakhna hai, is picture ko. Then just remember the farmer have to take the PGS certification, and PGS stands for participatory guarantee system, right? And now let's talk about the things that you have to remember. So there are only 2-3 things that you have to remember. First of all, you have to remember the launch year, that was 2015, along with the Atal Pension Yojana. Funding pattern, it is centrally sponsored scheme. So if any scheme is centrally sponsored, then the funding ratio between center and state is how much? 60:40. While if this state is a northeastern or Himalayan state, then this ratio is 90:10. While if it is UT, then 100% funding from the central government. All right. So if a scheme is centrally sponsored scheme, then in most of the schemes, this funding pattern follows. Okay. Budget allocation in this year's budget is how much rupees? 500 crores to promote the Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. And there is one portal which is known as Jaivik Kheti portal. Jaivik means organic, Kheti means farming. So it is a dedicated portal for organic farming, acting both as a knowledge platform and marketing platform. Ye portal launch kiya gaya hai under this scheme, Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. So isme ye basically knowledge platform ki tarah kaam bhi karega aur marketing platform ki tarah bhi kaam karega. Yahan pe jo farmers hain वो नॉलेज ले सकते हैं अबाउट दी ऑर्गेनिक प्रोड्यूस, और उस अपना जो ऑर्गेनिक प्रोड्यूस है उसको बेच भी सकते हैं. ओके, सो गाइस दिस वाज अबाउट द स्कीम. सो आई होप द स्कीम इज क्लियर, एंड लेट मी समराइज दिस वंस अगेन. सो परंपरागत कृषि विकास योजना, विच मींस द गवर्नमेंट इज प्रमोटिंग द ट्रेडिशनल वे ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर. एंड व्हाट आर द ट्रेडिशनल वेज? एज आई टोल्ड यू, कनेक्टेड विद द ओल्ड डेज व्हेन देयर वर नो पेस्टिसाइड्स, नो फर्टिलाइजर्स. व्हाट हम क्या करते थे उस समय? हम ऑर्गेनिक चीजों का इस्तेमाल करते थे. तो हेयर ऑल्सो गवर्नमेंट इज प्रमोटिंग द ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग. ओके, एंड दिस ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग इज प्रमोटेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ ट्रेडिशनल वेज एंड कनेक्टेड विद द टुडेज मॉडर्न साइंस. ओके, इट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2015, 2020-21 में इसका जो एलोकेशन है दैट इज रुपीज 500 करोड़. ओके, इसका जो मिनिस्ट्री ऑफकोर्स इज द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर्स वेलफेयर. नेशनल एडवाइजरी कमिटी होती है नेशनल लेवल पे for overall guidance of this scheme, and that is headed by the secretary in the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Okay, so guys, this was about the scheme, and now let's talk about the questions that can be asked in your exam. And very important thing, just remember the farmer has to take the PGS certification, jo ki uske produce ke labeling ke liye kaam aate hain. There are two types of labels, PGS India Organic and PGS India Green. All right. So under Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana, organic farming is promoted through a cluster based approach to adopt PGS certification. So what does PGS stands for? So as I told you, as we discussed, that PGS stands for, guys, participatory guarantee system. Option A will be the correct answer here. Then we have question number 2. What is the budget allocation for PKVY in the budget 2020-21? That's rupees 500 crore. Option C will be the correct answer here. And the question number 3 is, what is the launch year of Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana? So as I told you guys, it was launched along with the Atal Pension Yojana in the year 2015, which means option A will be the correct answer here. Okay guys, so that's it for the session. I hope the scheme is clear, and in tomorrow session I will bring to you 3 important scheme of the Ministry of Minority Affairs. Nayi Manzil, Nayi Udaan, Nayi Roshni. So these schemes are very important, and somehow they are related to each other also, because as you can say, all of them started with the word Nai. New, Nai means new. Okay. So, milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.